Jeremy Beyou returned to ports and was welcomed by a huge crowd of well-wishers. He has made it clear he wants to return to the race if the damage can be repaired in the true spirit of the Vendee Globe. Ever wondered what it's like being on the deck of an Amoca 60? Maxime Sorel goes for a little wander. Meanwhile, it was speed instruments. All eyes were on the wind and boat speed instruments last night, as many of the fleet hit speeds of over 24 knots during their voyage around Storm Theta. Away from the action at the front in calmer waters, it was mast climbing for some of the Vendee Globe skippers. Pip Hare coped admirably with her trepidation and summed up her first week in the iconic race perfectly.
Well, I've just had everything thrown at me in this first week. It's been incredible. The start was amazing. You know, despite the fact that France was completely locked down, people were out on their balconies cheering and shouting, and I had a small group of friends who came out with me and my team to the start. It was thick, thick fog. So we got delayed for over an hour, but then when we eventually left, it just felt right. It felt good, amazing to be going. And then we went straight out into this brutal front, 50 knots of wind. It's a huge amount of wind. I mean, that was just wild and wet and just about as awful as it can get. and then after that, the breeze has been up and down, and that means that I have to work really hard. You know, the boat's big, and if you just follow me up here, so those are just two of my sails there, and every time the conditions change, I have to lug these sails around, put different ones up in the air. So I've been working really, really hard to keep Medallia going. But we're doing well, considering she's the oldest boat in the fleet. We're hanging on to everyone, which is amazing. Today was another challenging day. I had to climb the mast today.
A couple of the elastic tiebacks on the second set of spreaders had broken. So I've decided now is probably the best chance I'm gonna have to go up the mast and fix them. I'm more than a little afraid, because I hate doing this, but the conditions are just about perfect. I've got all my kit together, so I'm gonna be climbing using this. Which basically belays me as I climb. And then I have this, which is a hand ascender and a foot loop. And of course, this, my helmet.
In bottles in the hotel lobby. Seems to me like I'm just scared of never feeling it.
Thank you so much. So, this broke here. And it's not critical, but it's not ideal. So, it's quite nice conditions. I thought I'd give it a go. I'm up. Coming down is going to be scary. Just need to do the job. But look at this. Look at all that horizon. Isn't it beautiful? Amazingly beautiful. If if I wasn't shaking. I'd appreciate it a lot more. Oh boy.
And we are heading towards the Azores. We're about 100 miles from the Azores. In front of me is Tropical Storm Theta. But it's going to be okay because I'm going to edge round it. It's 5 days. 5 days, and I feel like I've lived a lifetime. But this right here now, this is what I'm out here for. It's an amazing privilege to see this. Just this incredible expanse of horizon. I'm really in the middle of the ocean. I love it here, it's beautiful. I'll just share it with you.
Not to be outdone by Pip, Armel Tripon hoisted himself up the mast and took in the amazing views across the Atlantic Ocean.
Takes me back to when we started.
Still neck and neck between LeCam and Thompson, swapping the lead continuously while trying to cover the fleet behind them. VRSportTV will be bringing you regular reports throughout the epic race around the planet.